It's a folk tale from Pakistan, and it's called The Scholar and the Boatman. So it goes something like this. So a tall, distinguished man walks onto a river dock. Okay? He's dressed in long, dark purple robes, and he's got beautiful gold embroidery around his neck. He has a hat that's a small little cap and it matches his robe. And he has brand new shoes that were made for him the week before. He walks to the end of the dock and he sits down on a bench. Now this man is a great scholar. He's one of the most learned men in the region. And he's waiting for his boatman to take him across to the other side. Now he's sitting with a little bag, a leather bag, and there's some ancient manuscripts in it. And the sun is rising. And it's a beautiful sight. The sky, the horizon is pink and yellow and orange. And it's reflecting on the great Ganges River, the big mirror. And it's the most beautiful sight you can imagine. Now the boatman arrives faster than the scholar imagines. And so he comes, he gets to the dock, he ties up the boat, he gets out, and he greets the scholar. The scholar follows him, he installs him in the boat, he unties the boat, the ropes, and he begins to row across the great Ganges River. Now the scholar takes out one of his books, his manuscripts, and he starts to read. Now there's a silence between the men for a while, but the learned man cannot remain silent, and so he asks a question, and he says, "So, have you read any history?" And the boatman responds, "No, master, I have not read any history," as he continues to row across the great Ganges River. "Oh, such a pity, such a pity," says the scholar. "There's so many things to learn about history. You can learn about the empires of the ancient times. You can learn about the kings and queens. You can learn about the battles that they had. You can learn about the buildings that they lived in, the clothes that they wore, even the food that they ate. There's so much to learn about history." And then he returns back to reading his manuscript. Again, the boatman rows, and there's silence, and once again, the scholar asks another question. "So why haven't you read about history?" And the boatman responds, "Well, master, I never learned how to read." And he continues to row his boat to get them across the other side. Again, there's a silence. He goes back to reading, and he asks another question. "So, have you studied geography?" And the boatman responds, "No, master, I have not studied geography. "Oh, such a pity. There's so many things you can learn about studying the geographic maps of the world. You can learn that the world is round. You can learn about all the continents. You can learn about where the mountain ranges are, the great rivers. You can learn where they show you where you can find precious metals and stones and even spices. There's so much to learn about geography." "You," he says to the old man, "you know nothing. You know not geography. You know not history. Your life is hardly worth living." And he heads back to the king's boat. And the boatman does not respond, but he just keeps on rowing his boat across the great Ganges River. Again, there's a silence between the men. And once again, the scholar asks another question. "So, have you studied science?" And the boatman responds, "No, master, I have not studied science." "Oh, there's so much to learn about science. You can learn about the sun and the moon. You can learn how lightning is formed. You can learn the mechanisms of how rain comes out of the clouds. And scientists are such important people today. There's so much to learn." "You," he says to the boatman, "you know nothing. You know not history. You know not geography. You know not science. Life is hardly worth living. You might as well just be dead." And the The boatman does not respond, just keeps on rowing across the great Ganges. Now they reach the halfway point, and it's a very large part of the river that they're crossing. But all the while, that boatman was watching the weather. And there were some black clouds coming for them. He was pretty concerned about it because they were getting darker and darker, and he didn't know if they were going to make it across the river. At one point, the clouds are over top, and he says to the scholar, he says, these clouds are very ominous. You know, I've seen weather like this before, and it looks pretty serious. Do you know how to swim? And the wind picks up at this point, and the scholar is holding onto the boat, and he goes, in terror, oh dear, I don't know how to swim. At this point, it starts to rain, and it's torrential, and it's pouring, and boatman, he's trying his best to get across, but the boat fills up with water, and it sinks. Well, the scholar, he drowns, and he sinks to the bottom of the great Ganges River. And for the boatman, well, he just swam to safety to the other side.